Two possibilities exist. Either we are alone in the universe, or we are not. Both are equally terrifying. Arthur C. Clarke. What could be more horrifying than the idea that unknown extraterrestrial beings are clandestinely visiting the Earth for unknown purposes? In 1950, a top-secret Canadian government memorandum concerning the UFO phenomena revealed that the matter is the most highly classified subject in the United States government, ranking higher even than the hydrogen bomb. A Time magazine CNN poll, released in 1997, revealed that 80% of the adults polled responded that they believed the US government was hiding knowledge of extraterrestrials, and that 64% said they thought that aliens had contacted or even abducted humans. UFOs have been fired upon and attacked by jet fighters and anti-aircraft missiles with absolutely no effect. They evoke strange and fearful reactions in animals and frequently cause profound psychological disturbances in humans. UFOs appear on radar instruments and have been tracked, travelling at fantastical speeds, performing unbelievable aerial manoeuvres, such as 90-degree turns several thousand miles per hour.
The discovery of just one bacteria on Mars, or any other body of the solar system, would indicate that the whole chain of evolutions, cosmic, chemical, and biological, is at work everywhere. In that case, the creation of life anywhere in the universe would be more the rule than the exception. In that case, there may be other intelligent civilizations capable of communicating with us.
The most important truth is that the universe is like the ocean. It is teeming with life. Life will get a grip wherever it can. Life will evolve into any form and shape it can.
Each passing year has seen our estimate of the probability of life in space increase, along with our capabilities of detecting it. More and more scientists feel that contact with other civilizations is no longer something beyond our dreams, but is a natural event in the history of mankind.
Many abductions have occurred, and I do believe that they are occurring, and I do believe there's a reason for this new awareness and this sudden awareness of these abductions. And they always say that the way that the abductors communicate is through telepathy.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So if in fact this is occurring, so many people, Art has never had an abduction memory, I don't have an abduction memory, and yet I believe it's true.
We are to them perhaps as cows are to us.
I'm not comfortable with it either, but reality is going to be what it is, whether we're comfortable or not. That's what we're trying to figure out.
Yeah.
And then getting past the point of being uncomfortable or afraid or angry and all the other emotions that abductees go through, and people who come to understand this is true, whether they've had it happen to them or not, that they're aware of, you've got to get past that to the next stage. That's stage one. Stage two is now what do we do? But when we're talking about with the perhaps the transition to a species with more perceptive abilities, we have to learn to see what is happening to us, to perceive its reality, before we can ever respond and decide what response is correct.
Right.
It may well be that our response would be defensive. It may well be a response of accommodation. We cannot tell from channel material that is unverifiable which way we should be preparing.
What we see in the mainstream does affect how we view this topic, even if only unconsciously. The conditioning through official culture, which has fictionalized this topic, is deep and far-reaching. It cannot be underestimated. The question is, how to separate truth from lies?
And as I've said before, someone once said to me, oh, the people interested in this, it's just a cult. And I said, well, it's very interesting because this is the opposite of a cult. I said, a cult like the Moonies or whatever are all beliefs and no miracles. And I said, we're all miracles and no beliefs because we don't know what these things are for.
U.S. Army planes quickly took to the dark sky. But whether they contacted the object has not been announced. Although some watchers say they saw airplanes in the air, semi-official sources say they probably were the U.S. Army's pursuit.
Some people call them demons or demonic possessions. Some people call them fallen angels, and some say it's just a massive government MKUltra experiment. But whatever it is, there's no doubt that after decades of research, there is a phenomenon, whether aliens, demons, or something else, that has caused many to risk public ridicule by stating that they have been, in fact, abducted by aliens. A group of the population witness the same series of events and share a very similar narrative, a high number of whom seem to have an Rh negative blood type, a blood type that is absent any relationship to a primate ancestor, as 85% of the rest of the population share.
I am here to discuss the so-called flying saucers. The Air Force interest in this problem has been due to our feeling of an obligation to identify and analyze to the best of our ability anything in the air that may have the possibility of threat or menace to the United States. In pursuit of this obligation, since 1947, we have received and analyzed between 1 and 2,000 reports that have come to us from all kinds of sources. Of this great mass of reports, we have been able adequately to explain the great bulk of them, explain them to our own satisfaction. We've been able to explain them as hoaxes, as erroneously identified friendly aircraft, as meteorological or electronic phenomena, or as light aberrations.
Sir John Eccles, Nobel Prize winner for his research on the brain, describes the brain as, quote, a machine that a ghost can operate, unquote. What he means by that is your spirit operates your brain in a normal state of consciousness. In an altered state, reached under yoga, a TM, hypnosis, you have loosened the normal connection between your spirit and your brain, and that allows another spirit, other entities, other minds to interpose themselves and begin to tick off the neurons in your brain, create a universe of illusion. I believe that it's demonic.
Well, to oversimplify it, it consists of a feeling, in most cases, like the subject is being watched, and that there's some kind of feeling of impending dread. Something is about to happen. They feel it. They know it. They have a strong feeling they are being watched. At this point, if they are in a location, such as a public place, they might feel the need to go suddenly camping, or go to a forest or a very more remote location. At this point, they either have no memory of the event, or an event of missing time, or a strange feeling that part of their memory has been edited from their history. Here, if they remember the event, in most cases, they report the similar narrative. That narrative being taken into some kind of craft, room, or location where they have to look into the eyes of a creature, such as the classical grey alien.